In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to download and install itch.io games from the client app. Timestamps, links, and a written transcript with FAQ for this video will be in the description below. We'll want to start by going to itch.io where we can pick up the client app. After the front page loads, we can click the download app button at the top of the website. Another page will open to where we can download the itch.io client for Windows, macOS, and Linux. This tutorial is going to be for Windows, but the other platforms should be roughly the same in how we set it up. After clicking Start Download, a Save As window will pop up and you can save the itch setup to anywhere you prefer. I'll send it to my desktop for this tutorial. Now, find your itch setup and double click on it. A new window will pop up and by default, we can see itch will be installed to your C drive. If you want to change the destination, then click on Browse. From here, you can change your install location to another place on your computer. I'll be keeping it to the default location. Let's select Install Now. Once it's finished, it will automatically start up the client and you should have an itch shortcut created on your desktop. Before we can do anything regarding the client, we'll have to register by selecting it below the Login button. Your browser should open up to the register account page on itch.io and from here, you can enter the information needed to sign up. The only thing I'll note is that you can change your username after signing up, so no need to stress about picking a name. The rest of the sign up is self-explanatory. Finish it up, then click on Create Account. The website should log you in, and now we can use the username and password information for the client app. So let's go back and then enter our information and log in. The itch.io client is somewhat similar to the website. Something different is that you have Explore, Library, Collections, and My Creations on the left side. On the right, you can search by popular tags, randomizer, and even games by price. If we go to the top left and enter a letter or search term, we can find a specific game. After finding your game of choice, click on it and you will be taken to the creator's page. Look to the bottom right to see the install button and then click on it to open up a new window. From here, we can do a couple of things. One is having the option to install a 32-bit version of the game or 64-bit. Keep in mind, not all games will have this option, but if you have issues with the 64-bit version, then try 32-bit as it can be easier on some systems to run. The second box shows the location of where your games will install. This is the default location, but if you want to change it to another place, then click on the down arrow and select Add Location. Your Windows Explorer will show up asking where you would like your game to be installed. And that pretty much explains everything. I'd like to mention the disk space required to install and what you have available will be shown here. Let's click install and the game will take a bit of time to download depending on your download speed and the size of the game. At the bottom left, if you hit downloads, then a new window will come up with the time it will take to finish. After it is done, we can hit the launch button to start up the game. There is one last thing I want to point out. I noticed that some users in my previous video had issues where the game wouldn't start up when clicking launch. And if that is the case, here is something you can try. Click on the gear next to launch and go to manage. Choose open folder in Explorer. And then in the Windows Explorer that pops up, find the .exe to the game and start it up that way. If this doesn't work, sadly, then you may need to download the game manually from the itch.io website. I hope this tutorial has helped those who want a quick and easy way to install itch.io games. If you want to learn how to install them manually in case a game does not work when launching it, then check out this video. And if you want to learn how to install Gamejolt games, then check out this playlist. Feel free to subscribe to the channel and leave a like so YouTube can bump up this video for others to see. Thank you for watching and take care.